If I... Okay, okay. No, I'm going to sing Whitney Repeater. Should say I would only be in your way. And I will always love you.
This is a Stolen Legacy Revisited because, you know, our information changes and we add on to it or we adjust some things. Some of our great scholars, even Dr. Shekhar Anta Diop, some things have to be adjusted because of the new sciences. So this is the Stolen Legacy Revisited. I'm going to use some primary art just to add to George G.M. James's concept of the Stolen Legacy. So let's just do this. I'm showing you a vase. It's called a decorated war jar depicting ungulates and boats with human figures. Period. Pre-dynastic, late Nakata II. We're talking 3500 to 3300 BC. This is in Kemet. And this is in the Metropolitan Museum of Art. Now, let's take a look at this boat. In this boat, let's see if I can see it better on the next slide. I'll stay here. On this boat, we see about at least two people on this boat, this reed boat. And we see pyramids, and we see something that looks like the sun. And so we see a lot of decorations. This is 3,500 years BC. So we're talking 5,000 years ago. Here's another picture of it. Here we don't see the pyramids, or we see the pyramids on the second vase to the right. And we see this black family on this reed boat 3,500 years ago. Black family on a reed boat in Africa. Here you see pretty much what they saw as how they wanted to depict what they saw, antelopes and pyramids. Interesting. This is 3,500 BC. There are no pyramids at all, Sarnetta, at 3,500 BC in the world. So we think. That's why I'm doing this presentation called The Stolen Legacy. We look at this case at the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and we see lots of pyramids. And then to the far right, we see two sets of reed boats, and it looks like a sister with her hands up in the air, cherishing the sun, right? Having a relationship with the sun, loving the sun. Oh, shout out to Love Sun. So we have Africans in their world, black Africans in their world. Let's look at this closely. So there you see the sun, you see the sister, you see life is beautiful in the continent of Africa, and you see the pyramids. And this is 3500 BC, so we are roughly talking 5,000 plus years ago. These are Africans. But look, 600 to 100,000 years ago in southern Africa, there are some things called petroglyphs. These are drawings on molten rock in southern Africa. And here we see the sun, a depiction of the sun by Africans about 600 to 100,000 years ago. Look, in southern Africa, about the same time period, you have to relax your eyes on this. You see the Ankh inside the sun 600 to 100,000 years ago in southern Africa. You see that, Sarnetta? Mm-hmm. You see the Ankh inside the sun. Woo. And here you see Ray, the sun.
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow. You see a cross. You see signs and symbols of primordial man 600 to 100,000 years ago, drawn in rock formations in southern Africa. Look, you can find hundreds and thousands of these primordial signs and symbols in southern Africa in a place called Dry Cops Island in southern Africa. Now, you see this road right here? This is actually a road, right? Do you know, Sarnetta? They have trucks driving over this. See, the people in southern Africa, even the black southern Africans, they don't care about their culture, right? So they have trucks driving over primordial signs and symbols in Africa. Let's turn back to this vase again, and let's look at these pyramids and these diagrams to get you ready for the next view. This is a picture of southern Africa. Sarnetta, they don't want us to focus on this place. They want us to focus on America. They don't want us to focus on Africa. ISUPK don't care about Africa and Africans. The Moors care about Canaan. The other rest of the world cares about this place because in it is a stuff that created all of us. You ever see anything like this? But guess what? God cracks the sky every morning in South Africa for our people. Mm-hmm. But look at this, Sarnetta. In southern Africa, there are natural pyramids. See, remember I showed you these pyramids here? In southern Africa, they're natural pyramids. So these concepts of pyramid in this world is, in fact, this world right here. A primordial place that we come from. Africans. Look at this. There's the Ankh, 600 to 100,000 years ago. And then look, there is a Ankh that is 3,400 years, this is 3,400 years BC, sorry, in Kemet.
Why don't you get up and point to which one you're talking about so they know?
So this one is 3,400 BC pre-dynastic Kemet, and this one is in southern Africa. We could say anywhere 60 to 100,000 years ago in southern Africa. But this is pre-dynastic. Do you see the artwork in this? Mm-hmm. This is before Kemet was formed.
Damn.
Right? And this is in the Metropolitan Museum of Art. Look at this. Geometric shapes. This is what the African used to understand his world. I didn't show a night sky, but I'll get to that. Now, this is interesting. You see this right here? This is where those people lived in his temples, let's say 60 to 100,000 years ago, here in Michael Tellinger's book. This is something that they call Göbekli Tepe, right? That the Semitic people love. They say, oh, man, this is it before Kemet. They say this is before Kemet. Yes, yeah, before Kemet, but it ain't before Southern Africa. This dies, Sarnetta. This dies. And over here, Stonehenge. So Stonehenge is 6,000 years later than this, but this beats all of this by 50,000 years. And it's African. Black African power. Let's go back to this vase again. So we can show you the stolen legacy. See the vase? The African, the Nile Valley African, took these people 3,500 years ago before dynastic Kemet, and this was so sacred in their mind, right, that they used this in their cosmology, in their religion. Here, the things that you see is interesting. Maybe or maybe not, these are the T signs. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe, maybe not. This is the Y sign, the Y stabs. Definitely these are pyramids. Definitely these are rays of ray. Definitely this is a boat. This is technology. Definitely this is a beautiful black woman.
How old, right, is in the family?
Vase, 5,000 years old.
That vase right there.
5,000 years.
Hold on.
Nakata 2.
Hold on. That vase.
It's 5,000 years ago.
5,000 years old, brother?
5,000 years
no
old.
No scratches on it? No chips?
When we go to the museum, Sarnetta,
yes,
that's what we see.
That's right.
Right? That's what we
see. I just want you to make it clear for the people that's watching.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, it's going to get...
clear.
No, it's going to get deeper.
Yeah.
So this became our cosmology. So then the Ra, it says that the Ra was believed to travel in the Menjet boat, or the bark of millions of years. He was joined on a daily journey by a crew of many netters. The Menjet boat was sailed through the 12 provinces, 12, representing the 12 hours of daylight. Interesting. 12 disciples, 12 hours of daylight, right? At the end of each day, Ra was to die and embark on his night voyage, which is 12 hours in the night, another 12 disciples. One group of the 12 was women. The other group of the 12 was men. We had 12 women disciples. We had 12 men disciples. Ra was to meet them during each of the hours of the night. For this journey, he was called Auf, which means corpse. But here's the funny thing is, you see where it says he's called Auf? He's not called Auf. In Medinetcha, he's called Yaweth. Oh, sounds very familiar. As a corpse,
Yahweh.
Right?
Sounds like Yahweh a little bit.
Ra sailed in a boat called the Mescadet boat, or night bark, on his journey through the 12 hours of the night. But we get that from this. So then you see the day boat, and you see the night boat, and you see someone in between. In this case, it's a female. Let's move on. Look at this, Sarnetta. Remember those petroglyphs that I showed you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, guess what? Sarnetta, the land of South Africa, is full of these petroglyphs. Sarnetta, these are city-states. These are small towns and cities. I didn't put up the Egyptian Nuit sign. right, that shows the determinative for a city. But guess what? This is where the Nile Valley Newit sign comes from. You see these right here?
Uh-huh.
This is when you say Kemet, the charcoal and the T, and then you see the Newit sign, it comes from South Africa. Look, Africans still live like that today. Still live like that today. Oh, this is deep. Watch this. This right here is something called Adam's calendar, which is in that period, let's say 60,000 years ago. This is in Naphta Playa, which is roughly about 7,000 to 8,000 years ago in Naphta Playa. This is in southern Africa. This is in Naphta Playa next to Nubia. And they're charting the 26,000 year cycle. And then this becomes the Giza Plateau. So the Giza Plateau did not just come out of the sky. It was pre-done in Naphta Playa and pre-done before that in southern Africa. And then later you have Dogon technology. This is high science of black people. Check this out. Sarnetta. There is no Hebrews. Yes. No, but there is no Hebrews. Mm-hmm. No, you can read that. I'm just trying to get your attention. There are, I'm making a point. 60,000 years ago, 8,000 years ago, close to 2,400 years ago, right? Mm-hmm. And the doggone, there are no Moors. There are no Hebrews. They're no Christians. They're no Muslims. How do they want to take credit for something that they were not there?
That's a fact, man. Y'all really got to take a real close look at that right there, man.
How do you want to take credit for sciences that came from black people?
You know what gets me a lot, though, my brother Reggie? What gets me a lot, man, is when you look at this or you might be breaking down something. And the first thing a Hebrew would say, like, for example, Professor Smalls yesterday, he's breaking down Christianity and he's going in on ancient Africa. And then a Hebrew would come in the room and say, well, you know, he don't really understand the Bible. This is the most stupidest shit that I be hearing from these dudes, you know, and he don't understand. The only one that understand the damn Bible is Hebrews now. Everybody else, you read it, Dr. Ben, Amos Wilson, Francis Crest Welsing, I mean, Dr. John Henry Clark, Dr. Leonard Jeffries, Professor James Smalls, Infodigi, Shaka, Brother Reggie. I mean, we could go on and on and name these names. None of these grandmaster teachers don't understand the Bible. But guess what? Sincere. Chill out now.
But guess what? GMS understands the Bible. Yeah, they can go out there and rape little kids because they understand the Bible. But you don't see, that's the most stupidest shit that I be hearing from these so-called Hebrews. They don't understand. Oh, man, Dr. Ben don't really understand the Bible. These are grandmaster damn teachers. The only one understand the Bible is these fucking flunky so-called Hebrews on YouTube. Never been no fucking where. Never been no goddamn where. They the only ones understand the Bible. Most of them didn't even go to what they call a so-called holy land. None of them never even went to Israel. But guess what? Polite was there. Polite seen nothing but rocks. And everything is all rocks around their shit. You see what I'm saying? Jesus is a couple of feet away. And 10 feet away from Jesus, Moses, or
Abraham,
not Abraham, the Muslim, Prophet Muhammad, a few feet away. Come on, family. Stop playing games with this bullshit, man. The only one understand the damn Bible is Hebrew Israelites, because God spoke to you and told you what it really means. Crazy shit.
Well, I don't need to understand the Bible. My children and my children's children need to understand 26,000 year cycles already plotted by people that was living 60,000 years ago on, that they took the time in Southern Africa and then in Sudan and then in Kemet and then in Mali to do science. That's what I care about. I care about them understanding this whole process here and plotting it out, right, as they saw the sky. We're not out of space. We're in space, and we're having a relationship in space with what we call quantum physics, right? And all of these are aspects of quantum physics. And to say God is oversimplification, right? So we have a different, this is what we want black children to know. Sarnetta, people have never ever seen this in their life. This is this one of the sources of the Nile. This is Rwenzori. This is where the foothills of the mountains and the moon, where God happy dwelt, that Dr. Ben said. This is one of the sources of the Nile. People talk about this all the time. People talk about this all the time, but we never even care to look back. This is Africa, family. This is what you got to fight for. And you see this child right here, this sister right here? She is connected to all of this. You can see by her science on her body as she's going through her initiation, or she's showing her science. She is connected to this. This one, this young child right here, she can't eat at the ISUPK event. She no. can't. She can't. But she birthed us all. See, we weren't born in Canaan. We weren't born in, if we were born in paradise, this is paradise right here. And this sister, I put this picture up here to show the beauty of our black culture. Now, you could call her brown if you want. But you can't call her olive. Can't call her olive, right? Mm-hmm. And you could clearly see the white paint on her face to show the distinction between the colors. But the major point of this is one of the sources of the Nile. Dr. Ben said, we come from the foothills of the mountains of the moon where the God happy dwelt. I've done this presentation before. I'm not going to spend too long, except for here's the Metanecher and some of the, here's the Metanecher. And here is the translation where King Netuket, the pyramid builder, the Nosut of the pyramid age, he is speaking. He's speaking to Imhotep, and he's talking about Imhotep, where he says, he departed, he returned to me quickly. He let me know the flow of Happy, his shores and all the things that they contain. He disclosed to me the hidden wonders through which the ancestors have made their way, and no king has equaled them since, to which the ancestors have made their way, and no king has equal them sense. And so this is the side, this is the area where it says basically no king has equaled him since in this particular area right in right here. So in my paper, primary evidence that our ancestors came from the Nile, you could read that up in SlideShare and you could see my breakdown of this. And I'm not going to go through much of it, except to say in this passage, it says, the shrine I dwell has two lips. When I open up the well, I know happy hugs the field, a hug that fills each nodes with life, for which hug the field is reborn. I shall make happy gush for you, no year of lack and want anywhere. Earthly elevation, celestial hills, see the ray when he praises to give life to every face. His temple's name is the joy of life. The twin caverns is the water's name. The Twin Caverns is the water's name, and they are the breasts that nourish us all, right? So this helps us understand what Dr. Ben says. We come from the foothills of the mountains of the moon where God happy dwelt. My only point of bringing this up is to match our people's knowledge with where our people came from with primary text. So I'm going to move on. So our people take this boat that is 5,000 years ago, and then they make it important by now putting on formulas on this boat. Because on this boat that's traveling through the world and through the water, there's science. So they put their science. Here's Ra. Here's Horus. Here's Shu. Here's Tefnut, T-F-N-T. Here's Geb. This is Nut. This is Osir. This is Aset. And this is the Nosut. And he is on a solar boat. So they take this diagram. See how people remember what's good. And look at this. This is a depiction of Aset and Nebhet raising Osir. And in this process, let's just say, this says something like SKR, Seker, Neter, Osir, right? And he's talking about his the Jed, and he's talking about his heart. And then it says Jedet is a place. Anut is a place. And so they're talking about places that are important to this rising of Osiris, Osir. And they're talking, and they're giving a process here of what's happening. Why is this important? Wow. Oh, shoot. Sacred Nile Valley Science. Here's Inpu. Performing an opening of the mouth ceremony. And he's using this funny wand. And they say, Brother Reggie, why are they using a funny wand? What's this funny wand? And look, why they always got this meat on the table? You know, vegetarians go crazy. They see a meat on the table, you know? They go crazy. But it turns out that this wand, these are star systems. So they're opening up the mouth with star systems. See this right here? Mm-hmm. This is a star system. And you see over here, this is another star system. So this thing right here is a star system. It has nothing to do with what they think it has something to do with. It has something completely to do with transitioning to, remember, I said the reason why we are black is so we can see the stars, right? So we could become a star, right? And so here, this is Sacred Nile Valley science, right? Let's just see. Here is what they call...
Big Dipper.
That's correct. So this is the Adez. And the Adez is really the Big Dipper. And there are other utensils. You could read it on my chart. I'm not going to go into it. But I will say that this, when you go... See, y'all have to go. I'm starting tours in the Metropolitan Museum. I'm not going to do the tours. Like, I'm going to do some of the tours that I've done, the big tours with the House of Consciousness, Sarnetta Studios. Mm-hmm. But I'm going to start taking people weekly, like maybe 5 to 10 people on Saturdays to the museum, right? So because my whole point is to get as many people as I possibly can. So this would be sometime in May. I'll make an announcement. And then when I come out there on Saturdays and I collect 10 people and we go to the museum, it'll be about $20, $25 donation. And you'll walk with me and you'll see all this. But one of the things that you'll see over here is this very rare scene where this sister, you see this right here?
Uh-huh.
This sister is getting an afterlife and she's getting consciousness. And then on my tour, I'll break this down where... there is a conversation about this sister being righteous, right? And the heart is being weighed to Osir. And Osir basically tells her, give her her eyes and her mouth.
You say Usir. Is it Asar or Usir? What's the proper way to pronounce it?
We don't know. So why don't we don't know how it's pronounced? Okay. We use a formula, right?
Some of us say Asar, some of us say Usir.
That's correct.
Mean the same person. We know.
Right. So Osiris, Usir, Asar, right? He is giving this woman her eyes and her mouth, and you see, this woman is getting consciousness in the afterlife. You show me one Bible, you show me one Torah, you show me anything in the Quran where you see a woman depicted getting consciousness in the afterlife by herself without marrying a man. Her heart is being weighed by the feather of truth. This is what Brother Small was showing. So we have all the symbolisms, but the more important thing is, you see this meat right here? Mm-hmm. And this is this right here. Right? This is the Ursus, right? Which is Ursus Major, which is part of the Big Dipper, and this is the sacred science that we're doing. Oh, shoot. Here is the opening of the mouth. This piece right here is actually in the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and these are the these contain the magic substances that are used to purify and to open up the mouth. And this is what Professor Small used, in a sense, to open up the mouth of Dr. Ben. And this is the blade. And this is the science behind this particular metal that is used for the opening of the mouth. It's a special metal because we know science. And we use the metal for a particular scientific reason, because some of the stuff was actually meteorite metal, right? So but the major point of this is that this is not spooky in the sense that there is, these remind us of purity. And the reason why we open up the mouth, Sarnetta, is different than other people. We open up the mouth with the magic knife called the Pesachef. We open up the mouth because what we try to do during that day is to try to get everything good that this deceased person said and to put it in our library, right? To put it in our library, Sarnetta. So what we don't do is what the Moors do, the Muslims do. And shout out to all my sisters that be watching, and definitely Miss Yum Yum 69. Definitely Sci-Fi. Definitely Love Son, a new kid, Kimmich student. Man, there are so many sisters that support this. And I'm doing this for y'all because people think Kimmich is about men. It ain't about men. It's about women's sacred science. So let me just get through this because I gotta leave Sarnetta and Sister Sin's house because I've been spending too much time here. Again. This is the sister. This is Hatshepsut's temple. So we know it's a female. This is her feet. These are the steps that lead to her sacred womb, right? And where people are born and they come out through these steps. So we go in and we come out. This is the sacred calf. There is only one way in here. Is through her womb, and this is where all civilization is born, in a woman's womb. And remember I talked about the 12 hours of the night and 12 hours of the day and do it? So here are the 12 females, right, that nourish us all. And so I basically said that tea is... We're trained not to see this, but tea is in all of our sacred sciences. And here's Sheshet here. And to understand this symbol, one thing is unified. Women is unified in Kemet because the majority of women have a T in their name. And I showed that black women get salvation, and I'm going to show it again. Here, you could come with me. You can see these sacred sciences of black women on their womb. Here, I love to do this. This is the first depiction of pink being used in a funerary artifact. But these are the sacred sciences of black women. This is this is the top of this particular lid of this black woman, and this is her sacred science. And here's her science right here. You see her arms crossed in the kepara. That's sacred science of black women. Right? Christianity is not going to give you that. Islam is not going to give you that. The Moors ain't going to give you that. Hebrews are not going to give you that. Women have their own sacred science. Right? And this is why we do this work. And I showed it before with this tomb right here. You see this tomb right here? Well, guess what? Europeans borrowed this because this is Capitol Hill. And this is that same tomb. And this is the womb. Right? So you have the two houses, the feet and the head, and all laws are made right here in Congress. So you have the House and Senate, you have Congress coming together, and laws are born. Here is what they call the temple of man, but what's really the temple of female, where you walk in, you go into the sacred womb, life is formed, the holiest of holies is in the head. They took this from our people. They built a civilization on African people. They ain't build the, this ain't got nothing to do with no Moors. This ain't got nothing to do with no Christians. This ain't got nothing to do with no Islam. This definitely have nothing to do with no Hebrews. This is straight Nile Valley culture stolen to African culture. Right? This is our science. Oh, shoot, sir. This is the Vatican in St. Peter's Square. Look at this. You come through the legs. You go into her sacred vagina. You get born in the womb. You go straight to her holies of holies. This is a female. In the middle of this right here, you know what this is? This is the tekenu, the penis. That's what Brother Small showed the other day, right? Mm-hmm. Here is it. So they use this and it said nothing works inside the womb without the penis. So you know. This is straight Nile Valley science. This is a tekenu. This is an obelisk right here in the middle of the womb. But people don't see it from the sky, so they don't know that it's a womb. This is where Christian laws are born in Vatican Square. Male and female qualities coming together. Okay, let's move. Okay, so this is one. This is India, same thing. The feet. Sacred womb, right? Laws are born, or power shown. There's women in our in their sacred science. And inside the womb, this is an Abel symbol. So this is the great initiation in Abel symbol. I didn't show the whole thing. And there's the holiest of holies. But inside the womb of this temple, and all temples are wombs, this is where you are made an initiate. And these are so hard, I mean, this is so huge that between each pillar, you could fit like 40, 50 initiates on each side, right? And they don't look this way. In my other lecture, Dr. Ben taught us they look as Ray comes in, because Ray comes in and lights each piece of the Meta Netcher at different times when Ray comes in. So I didn't show that today. I did want to show... again, this sister is getting an afterlife. You ain't gonna find this in the Bible, the Torah. You ain't gonna find this in any more science. You're not gonna find. You're not gonna see a sister getting salvation. You're just not gonna see it. And then we go into some symbols. He's sitting on his square. He sits on his square. You see a Set and Nebhet, right? And this is Nebhet. This is says a Set, and you see the Bayadet, and you see this person getting her salvation. And the beautiful thing is, guess what? She's on her boat herself paddling for salvation. She don't need no man. Watch this. In Nile Valley culture, every human being gets salvation based on their heart, what they do. And here in this credible picture, you see this sister doing it by herself. She don't need no man. She don't need no helper. She's paddling for her salvation by herself. She has no mediator between herself and the afterlife. It's just her and her good deeds. So let's look at this. Let's look at this over here, Sa. So here you see. She's on the journey. I didn't put up the whole piece. On this side over here, she passed through. She passed through a pep.
But let's make it clear. I want to make it clear right now.
Yes.
My brother Reggie is not saying that she don't need a man in her life. That's not what he's saying. He's talking about on the journey that she's going through for her salvation. I want to make that clear because you know you're going to have Negroes saying, oh, Reggie said the black woman don't need a man. That's not what he's saying, family. That's not what he's saying.
Thank you, Sarnetta. I always need some help to make things clear because, you know, this is going around the world.
That's right.
So let me put it like this, right? She don't need no Christian man, no Hebrew man, no Islamic man, right? They have nothing to do with her salvation. They have something to do with her life and her children on this earth, right? But they don't lead her when it comes to salvation. That's what I meant. She needs teachings, but you don't see any of them with her, right? Once she gets the teaching, once she's taught, she herself can do it. And we have a system where we teach our women and they can do it themselves. All right. So let's here. This is beautiful. Here, same sister. This is the lake of fire. This is hell. This is hell. This, I think this is Amonani, funerary papyrus. Here, guess what? She barely passes it. She's on her knees, getting past hell, going over, I think, to the reed fields, or I could check, or to the Akhet, to the horizon. She, and these are the spells. The most important part of this Amunani, and they won't give us the whole papyrus so that we can translate it ourselves. We can barely read this stuff, right? They won't do it for us because they know that this is very important to black women because this is a huge papyrus. Okay, so, yeah, we got...
Black power.
Yeah, we got black power.
Black power.
We got signs and symbols. So we have signs and symbols. So I'm just going to go through the signs and symbols. I'm not going to talk about them, right? But you see Masons doing their signs and symbols. We Africans have signs and symbols, right? Oh, shoot.
The Nation of Islam be doing that too, a little.
Of course. Well, here you have, it could be Ramesses, but look.
That's Ramesses, yes.
But look at this. Over here, you have Abraham. But he's sitting on his square. He's sitting on a square because, so we don't need, see, we see a lot of these organizations like the Moors and members secretly in the Nation of Islam, they are Masonic and all these other groups, uh-huh. Right? They get that from us, right? And so we don't need them to teach us that.
Right, go through that again. Look at that. There it is. Oh.
Look at the sister.
Man.
Sisters.
Symbols,
sisters got signs and symbols. Sisters got signs and symbols. She, this is so incredible. She got her left foot forward. She got the jet in her hand. She's giving to you in the front and the back.
And look at her foot stepping forward.
That's right, on the left foot. Right?
They go. Look at that. Hold up, don't the Moors do that? Hold up their hand. Look at this shit.
Yo, Islam, 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 Islam.
Where do it come from? Look at this one right here. Holding up the hand. Islam. She's saying Islam. It all come out of here, baby. Look at this. Look at this right here, holding up the hand. Islam.
But we don't need.
Come on, but we'll. Come on, man. It all come from us, man.
And so, though a little more, he checked me because he said, well, my feet were apart and I wasn't on my square. No, we stand on the square. We kneel on the square. We don't necessarily put our foot in the square.
Now, I bet you,
left foot forward.
You might come across the Muslim Salah.
Oh, yeah, I skipped that. So,
now,
look.
Go back. Hold on. You got to go back because this shit is important. Showing you the symbols that we've been doing. Look, hold up. There you go. That's who's that? That's,
That could be Ptah.
That's Ptah. That's exactly who it is. Or Imhotep.
It could be. They don't have too many pictures of Imhotep. So, it's
holding up the Islamic sign that you see today with the Moors saying Islam. Come on, bro. It all come from us, man. Oh, there you go. Go back. Right there. Look at that right there.
This is a sister. This is Hatshepsut. She's got the apron. Hatshepsut has got an apron on, a Masonic apron, or an apron that became the Masonic apron, and she, here she is with her knife. This is Hatshepsut right here, on that. Her square, right? On her square. On her square. A sister.
Put the left foot forward.
On her square, right? So we don't need those little fancy things that they do, and they don't. I don't need to be checked. Here's another sister in her pose, the brother, Mentu Hotep. This sister looks like Queen T. Aset and Nebhet. This is Aset and Nebhet, right? In their pose, right? This.
Look how the copy comes.
This
look
is
at the copycat.
There you go.
Look at the copycat.
There you go.
Right there.
So this is Greek.
Uh-huh.
And this is European. This is masonry.
And what date?
I don't. This has got to be the same period that I talked about. Earlier, this is Ptolemy, I think. So this is about this could be 350 BC, roughly 380, a period of that particular period. And this is anywhere in Africa earlier. Mm-hmm. Oh, here's a brother and his sister, right? See that symbol, the way the brother's doing? He got something in his hand. And here's the sister on their square, together. Mm-hmm. We're talking about African civilization. Right? Here's another pose. Brother, same pose. Left foot forward. Sister on her square. Completing. See the symmetry, the squareness. Right? It comes from us. You see her? What's she doing, Sa? Right angle. Mm-hmm. Right? So we don't need them to tell us our science. Right? Okay, here's the famous hands crossed. Right? This is the left foot forward with the staff. One of the wise stabs, he could be a hymnetcher. Here's another sister, basically like opening up the way, doing tribute. Oh, look at these sisters getting down. Huh? Mm-hmm. Right? Oh, this sister, look at her. She is doing a funerary situation, right? Oh, you want to do tassels? It's a real tassel right there, huh? You want to do a tassel during a ceremony? Black power. Look at that tassel right there. Right? Look at that. Okay. Watch her hair. Because they use hair in these rituals. Oh, shoot. Saw a set. Look at the hair. I mean, a set and Nebhet. A set and Nebhet and Osor, and look at the hair. Signs and symbols of primordial man. Black man. Right? Mm-hmm. And we don't need nobody to tell us our signs and symbols. Oh, shoot. Look.
Man, all these masons you see today, they get all of that from us, man. They took our science. Look at that.
Look at the hand.
That was our science, man.
Look at the handshake. Look at the handshake. You ever seen this handshake right here? So this hand is going within the thumbs. And then it's touching.
The masons do that to this day.
Look. Look at this hand. But look at this. You see the thumb touching? You see the other person's thumb touching and the hands, mm-hmm. Right? So when Dolo
the
Moor,
huh? That's the secret, man. The secret is that's your science that they use it, family. All of that belong to us, man. This is our secret shit.
And
that's the secret.
Right. And so guess what, y'all? This are women doing the signs and symbols, mm-hmm. Right? So you see our brother Dolo the Moor doing signs and symbols, right? I respect his signs and symbols.
Right,
but they don't mean nothing to me.
Right.
They mean nothing to me because I don't think like that. I'm not conditioned like that. I care about this. If I could see our sisters do this, Sarnetta, show this. If I could see our sisters do this symbol, you see this right here? It's like right angle, sisters touching their hands together, right? Mm-hmm. Man, we moving toward freedom. We don't need them. We just need to go back. And you're not going to get this being a Hebrew. You're not getting this being a Christian. You're not going to get this being a Moor. You're not getting this being a Hebrew Israelite. You're not getting this being a Jew. You're only going to get this if you black African. Black African power. We're going to finish up. You've seen this before with the Ankhs. You see Samaj do this. Mm-hmm. You see Infidishi and Samaj
do
this. My elder Haru Samaj, He's the Ankh man, and you've seen all of our elders come out. Since I've been coming out, you've seen all the elders come out. Black power. So you see Samaj, right? Uh-huh. So Heru, Baba Heru Samaj, this is where he's getting from that. He's giving signs and symbols of primordial man. Oh, shoot.
Hold on. There you go.
See, this is the thing is, we respect order. We have no problems bowing to law and to rule, to righteous rule. So here you see two brothers in the posture of complete obedience. Right? Right? And they gave them beards, you see? Mm-hmm. To hold up their head. Right? In support.
Now, there you go. See that?
Yeah.
That's where the Muslims get that from. Look at them bowing down in submission or something, whatever they're doing. Go in on that, Reggie.
Yeah, well, in this case, obviously she is having this particular, she's in the afterlife and she's facing the evil crocodile in this afterlife. Or he may not be evil, he may be Sobek. But the fact of the matter is that she is toe-to-toe with this character. But it is a sign and symbol of primordial man. Oh, then we get to West Africa. Mm-hmm. Because they say Egypt ain't got nothing to do with West Africa. So you see him in his posture from the Congo. From the Congo.
Hold on, look at that. Look at that. Don't the Muslims do that to this day?
From the Congo.
On their knees with their hands on their right and left leg? Come on, man.
So it has dispersed. Oh, shoot. This is in the Congo. And this is in Kemet.
Look at that. Kemet has influenced the damn world. You got to give it to them.
This is in West Africa, the Congo. Where when I showed those pictures of those Africans being captured by those dudes that Sharif Bey says is the force publique that weren't Moors. Mm-hmm. These are the people being captured. Right? And they got their science from Kemen. Almost finished. Here's a real picture of an African man in his posture and his doing his science with his work. His science. Oh, shoot. These are sisters that look like a Set and Nephet. Right? Mm-hmm. I know this is a little too hard for them, right? Mm-hmm. Leopard skin cloths, right? Right? I know this is just too much for our people because we only like to deal with stones. We don't like to see a living culture. Mm-hmm. Right? This man actually looks like Dr. John Henry Clark. Mm-hmm. And he is with his work, right? Sorry, this is not clear. Sometimes you take it up. This is not clear, but you see they have the statue in front of them. this is African warfare right here. Guerrilla warfare. You go fight these brothers in the bush. You come up on one of these trees, but they men, right? But they doing their signs and symbols. Now, West Africa, when you go on a trip with me, you see the Horus Baedat. You see Tahuti. Sorry, this is not clear. It's clear on the computer. It's just not clear on the screen. You see African Nile Valley artifacts all over West Africa. Oh, shoot. I think I'm almost closing with this. This is the Atef crown of Tutankhamun. Here is the same crown in West Africa. I said I always wanted to do this. There's an elder. We have all these elders. We have Brother Heru. We have Infadishi Jehudi Mas. We have Heru Samaj. We have Infadishi Jehudi Mas. We have Professor Small, who is in the craft. And we have this brother right here, Brother Patah Seeker. My elders, they come and they say, well, you know, Brother Reggie, you know, look, our people, we don't know how to count. Brother Patah Seeker, he does the solar calendar that our ancestors used. And he is one of the best authors. Him and another system or similar system is Dr. Riketti Ahmed. But if you Google solar calendar, you can get his system, because he's saying, yo, we don't know what time it is. We're not connected. We're connected to the Christian calendar. We're not connected to an older African calendar. And he says, you know, Brother Reggie, he called me up and said, Brother Reggie, you can't count. He nice to me, but you don't know the time of the day. And I have to take it from my elders until I get it. They call me up all the time. Calls me up, Brother Reggie, you can't count. You know you can't count. Right? So I'm going to click off of that. So, brothers and sisters, I wanted to end with that. My shirt comes from Brother Al. Brother Al, he is selling these shirts. You know where his hat comes from. I don't think I want to take too many phone calls, right? Because I'm not. How can I say my book is closed until April 10th. What I wanted to do for our people is give our people, Professor Small, who is my elder, Dr. Jeffries is my elder, but Professor Small came, and he gave a powerful, powerful, powerful presentation yesterday. And all my job is to do is to try to complete some of the knowledge and to help all of us is to help our people see that there's another path. The record of Christianity, Islam, the Torah, it's been closed. There's no new information.